that is burning in your heart. That you want to get out of this place. I want you to go before the throne of grace. Go before the throne of God. And ask that one thing. One thing that you want to get from this conference. Let us go before the Lord now. Open your mouth and pray.
His son. And he said to him, do you believe?
Jesus said,
yes,
your faith has made you well. Not my power. Not my power as Jesus. But your faith has brought the miracle. It is not just the power of God. Because the power of God is there whether you know or you don't know it. Whether you believe it or not, the power of God is there. But when you raise your bar of faith, you connect with God, and God can release some things for you. I came to tell you today, God wants you to go higher. God wants you to go higher. Higher in your prayer. Higher in your gifts. Higher in your calling. Higher in revelation. Higher in receiving from God. But you need the higher level of faith. Can you say amen? I want you to tell your neighbor. Tell them today. Thank God for the faith you have had. Thank God for the faith you had last year. For the faith you had last month. Thank God for the faith that made you a believer. But shake them again. Shake your neighbor again. And tell them the next level where you're going. I don't hear you. Tell them where you're going needs a higher faith. Thank God for what you have received from God. But where you're going, your eyes have never seen. Your ears have never heard. Your mind has never conceived it. That's where God is taking you. And He's telling you, for you to receive what you've never seen. For me to receive what you've never had. For me to use you more than you've ever imagined. Where God is taking you, no prophecy has ever revealed it to you. Because it's a new thing. God is creating it now. And so you need another level of faith. Raise your right hand. Say, Jesus,
Jesus,
raise my faith.
Raise my faith
to the next level.
The next level.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Clap your hands for the Lord.
Amen.
When God is about to take you to another level, God saw Abraham.
Imanenge Abraham.
With a barren old woman.
Afite umudamu w'ingumba.
And she's very old.
And
God says, I need to change this man. Because I need to tend to make this man a father of many. And there's a way of testing whether he believes what I'm going to do for him. I want to talk to him as if he understands what I'm saying. I want to test him and see if he understands what I'm saying. And God came to Abraham and said, Abraham, Abraham, depart from your country. Depart from your father's house. Depart from your very people and go to your country, I will show you. I'm not giving you the GPS coordinates now. I'm not even giving you the name of the country for now. It's a country I'll reveal to you later. And Abraham sits.
Abraham Alichara.
Could this be God? Who is telling me to leave the very place that people have known for many years? I've lived in this place for years. Is it him who is telling me to leave? Abraham had two options. Because God will never force you. God will never force you. He's a God who loves your free will. Those of you who think God will force you to serve Him, I'm sorry for you. God simply entices you. He gives you opportunities. And he observes how you treat those opportunities. And God said, let me see if Abraham understands what I'm saying. Is he going to accept to leave to go an unknown territory? Or is he going to refuse and say, I'd rather stay with whatever I know than going to whatever I don't
know?
Whatever you don't know with God is better than what you know without God. Whenever God tells you something you don't understand, but He says, I will be with you. But He says something to you and you don't understand how it can happen to you. That thing that God says, I will be with you, is better a million times than something that you know but God is not in it. For example, if God says, I want you to leave India now and go to your country X and I'll be with you. That country X is better a million times than India, where you have all the connections and everything you know. And God washed
Abraham.
Abraham went and announced to his father, Terah. And his neighbor. And he said, I'm leaving. And he said, where are you going? He said, I don't know. But God said, I must leave you. He said, what do you mean? He said, I mean what I just said. God has told me to depart from my father's house and from my country and go to a country to
show me.
And they looked at me and said, you must be crazy. And that was the first test Abraham passed. For him to leave his country, leave his family, leave his relatives, and just go to an unknown territory. And God said, I can work with this man. Because he doesn't depend on what he knows, but what I say. Hallelujah. Listen to me carefully. If you learn to obey what God says and do not doubt at all, the world will look for you. But if you choose to follow what you know You will look for the world. Now I want you to decide which is better. Do you want to look for the world, or do you want the world to look for you? Who can give me an answer? Do you want to look for the world, or do you want the world to look for you? You want what? You want the one to look for you. Very good answer. If you learn to listen to what God is saying and obey 100%, or maybe try to obey, and even when you fail, you come back and say, Lord, I messed up, but I've come back. I announce to you, I don't care where you come from, I don't care how many sins you have committed, I don't care about your weaknesses. One thing I know, if you learn to obey the voice of God and have faith in God, you
will
be above everybody else in your family.
Nations
will look for you. You will not run after nations. Let me make it clear. Somebody here, when you follow what I'm saying, I prophesy to you, I see a nation begging you to receive the assistantship. If you obey what God is telling you, and you follow the voice of God, in the spiritual world right now, I see government officials begging somebody here, one of you here. It's one country. They are negotiating with one of you here. They are begging, can you accept to be? Can you accept our citizenship?
We'll
give you our citizenship. And it is one of the greatest countries. If you obey the voice of God and do not doubt in your heart, nations will look for you. But if you choose to be like everybody else, you will run after nations and they will slam doors in your eyes. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
So Abraham, God tests him in the first test.
Abraham, he
accepts to leave his country. Yeah. In Genesis chapter
12.
To go to a country God will show him. But I want to talk about two pillars of faith. A pillar is like that post there.
Thank you.
Two pillars of faith that make you see your life take a different. That will make you see your life turn around. And God will be glorified in your life. The number one pillar of faith is its source. The source of faith is the word of God. The source of faith is the word of God. That's pillar number one. Pillar number one of faith is its source, which is the word of God. Your faith should not be based on anything else. Your faith should be in the word of God. In other words, what God says is what matters. Not what you know. What God says, whether in the Bible or in the revelation, or in a prophecy, or in a dream, however God speaks to you, whether it is the revealed word of God or a written word of God, that must be the basis for your faith. The Bible says in the book of Romans, Romans chapter 10, verse 15. Faith comes by hearing. Hearing the word of God. Faith comes by hearing. And hearing the word of God. In other words, what you hear can determine who you become. What you hear determines what you receive. Not your circumstances. Not your background. What you hear from God, what God says in His Word, if you choose to believe it, it will determine